Welcome to a new video. This tutorial will show you how to repair the instrument clusters of Mercedes SLR230 and SLR McLaren, replacing both screens with two pieces of Minitools SEPDISP71 replacement. For this repair, you will need the following tools. Position the dashboard as shown, and with the aid of the spudger, act on the plastic clips to remove the front cover. Undo and take off the rear one as well, as shown. Remove the central button. Fit the gauge face protective disc and take out the speedometer and RPM needles, gently rotating and pulling them. With the spudger, unhook and remove the numbered frames of the gauges as shown. With the aid of the spudger and the protective disc, undo the rest of the overlay. Open the connectors of the two FPCs. Unplug them and remove the screens. Peel off the protective films from the new Minitools displays and fit and secure them in their housing as shown. Plug the two FPCs, closing the connectors. Carefully follow the following instructions before reassembling the dashboard. Switch on the panel. With a multimeter, measure the voltage on both displays between the points indicated and take note of it. If the voltage measured for both screens is between 7.25 and 7.35 volts, the problem is solved. Otherwise, to adjust the voltage and the display contrast, it will be necessary to do a modification of the EEPROM 93C86 with a specific programmer. Switch off the dashboard and with the aid of the curved tip probe, remove the metal shielding cover from the back of the panel. Rotate the cluster to easily reach the apron, and with some Ketton tape, thermally insulate the components around it. Memorize the apron soldering direction as it has to be soldered back, exactly the same way. With a hot air desoldering iron, desolder the apron with the aid of the tweezers. Clip the apron connecting it to the programmer. Set the reading in hexadecimal and make a backup. Identify on the apron the location 03AE, on which act for the left-hand side display, and 03C6, on which act instead for the right-hand side display. Scanning the QR code or following the link on the product label, open the PDF with instructions to use the specific calculation tool to do the modification. To correctly carry out the modification, type in the values related to your defective dashboard. Those used in the video are for illustrative purpose only. Type in the first box the voltage measured before for the left-hand side display. In this case, the voltage was 7.18 volts. Then, type in the value of the 03AE location in its related box, in this case 22. The tool will automatically calculate the new value, 24, to insert in the location on the EEPROM. Repeat the operation for the right-hand side display, typing in first the voltage measured, in this case 7.01 volts, then the 03C6 location value, in this case 21. The new value to type in the location will be 25. Save the file just modified and upload it on the EEPROM. unclipped the EEPROM from the programmer. Before soldering it back, remove the tin excess from the PCB with a soldering iron with chisel tip and the solder wick. Clean with some solvent. With the tweezers, position the EEPROM on the PCB as it was originally and solder it using a soldering iron with conical tip at 350 degrees. Clean again with some solvent. Remove the Kapton tape. Switch on the dashboard again and with the multimeter recheck the voltage for both screens. If the voltage, as in this case, is now between 7.25 volts and 7.35 volts, the modification was successful. If the voltage has not changed after the EEPROM modification, we recommend contacting us by email at info@minitools.com. Reattach the metal shielding cover. Put back the overlay. And the numbered frames. Position the needles and with a Minitools shim, put them at the right level. Then bring them back to their original position. Fit the rear cover of the panel, gently placing inside the NTCs of the displays, FPCs as shown, so to avoid any damage. Put back the central button and fit the front cover. Switch on the dashboard. Perfetto! Problem solved! Thank you for choosing Minitools.